This call is now being recorded.
Okay, Kazuo Ishiguro's novel, An Artist of the Floating World, title. Let us see the title and the what is the meaning of the title. In the present introductory presentation by students, Khushbu and Lata, yes, they have dealt and they have also explained that what is the meaning of the title and how do we read the title also. Artist of the Floating World. So obviously artist. So this is a story of an artist that we come to know, and our protagonist is an artist. Our protagonist is the narrator also, and his name is Masuji Ono. Masuji, M-A-S-U-J-I, Masuji Ono, O-N-O. Masuji Ono is our narrator. He's an artist and he's an old fellow now. His entire career was painting and the thing that he has done. Okay, so artist, that point is very clear. There is the story about an artist, an old artist who is revisiting his memory of childhood and younger days. Now, artist of the floating world. Now, this word, this phrase, floating world, is quite problematic. When we try to find what is the meaning of the floating world, one easy meaning that we get or we tend to give here is that floating world must be changing world, must be changing world, the world that is changing, and how this artist is facing some kind of troubles, problems in the changing world. When an artist is growing, Masuji Ono, when he is growing from his childhood to younger days, and he is cultivating a kind of we can say habit of drawing a particular kind of paintings. What is this particular kind of painting? That is nationalistic painting, full of nationalism and imperialism. Japan was ruled by an imperial ruler, Hirohito. Hirohito was the ruler of Japan. He was emperor of Japan, 124th emperor of Japan, Emperor Hirohito. And during that time, Japan was a very aggressive country, a very aggressive imperialist countries, means they always want to expand their boundaries. They are always attacking other countries. So in the story of Hirohito, we find that he has there was this Sino-Japanese War. Sino means China. Sino, S-I-N-O. S-I-N-O. Sino-Japanese War means war with China and many other countries also. So during this time, that is leading to the Second World War or the first 50 years of 20th century. By the end of the Second World War, we find that Japan is a very imperialistic country who keeps on attacking neighboring countries also. Now, today it is very surprising to see that Japan might have attacked China, because today China has become such a mighty power. China has become and Japan seems to be a very, very innocent little country, innocent little small country in the corner. If you see the map of Japan, you find very much in the corner, you find a small country, Japan, where China is a very large country, very powerful economically, militarily. So to think that somewhere Japan attacked and defeated China and also grabbed larger part of land also of China is very surprising also. Now, in this time when your rulers, emperor is warmongering, is waging war with another countries. And whenever see this, we have seen in 1984 also, whenever political leader, emperor, monarch, king, whoever is the ruler, Big Brother or Hirohito, whenever they wage war, they always justify. And their justifications are fair and square. They are always in terms of nation, that we are doing this for our country. We are doing all this thing for our country, our nation. For us, national interests are always first. And so we all have to support that war. If you are against that, means you are against nation. Whatever decisions the political authorities are taking, if you do not agree with that, it means you are anti-national. Nowadays in India, we have one interesting struggle going on, a kind of a government struggle with a private company that is Twitter, private American company. Twitter and government of India, they have locked their horns. the court case and things are going on. Now, in this case, if you say that, well, I am with Twitter, then you may have to listen that you are anti-national. You should be with your government rather than with some American company. That is where you display your love for your country also. So you come into a very fixed situation that should I say anything in favor of Twitter or not? Can I become an anti-national if I take a side of Twitter or not? Obviously, private companies have their own dangers also. And private companies, if they are so powerful that they can defeat the elected democratical government, then it is more harmful there. But this situation is much different also. The situation is very complex. So taking sides is very difficult. Easiest way is to be with the emperor, be with the king, be with monarch, be with big brother, be with your party. That is easiest way. So perhaps Masuji Ono also choose the side to be with nationalist people. And he started making the paintings about nationalism. And he also, in those paintings, one of the paintings which is very, very important and significant, which was the painting of the first painting that he has drawn and which became very popular also. And that there he is showing the army jawans and call for the war and motivating young people to join military. So militarism that is going on, and he is taking a side of that. So he has painted those things. Now Second World War, and we know that Japan was defeated by America and the allied nations. And they have to surrender. Japan has to surrender. And ultimately, when Japan was not surrendering, America has to drop atomic bombs. And without that, there was no answer. So Hiroshima and Nagasaki, two towns where two bombs, atomic bombs, were dropped. And then Japan came down to the knees. And it surrenders to America. And that is the beginning of Americanization of Japan also. That is the beginning of Americanization. Then America took responsibility of Japan in the rebuilding of Japan. And so Americanization, Westernization of Japan begins with that. So after Second World War, time is changing. Now, earlier it was imperialism. You are with Hirohito. You are with your ruler. And you are nationalistic. You are imperialist. You believe in militarism. Now suddenly people have started talking that was a bad decision by our ruler. We should have not gone for war. So many people died, and such a damage that Japan has suffered. And who is responsible for that? And then we find that not only emperor, but anybody who supported militarism, anybody who supported imperialism, anybody who supported war, they all those nationalists are responsible, including those who were singing the songs and inspiring people to go for war, including the painters who were painting those pictures and inspiring people to go for the war, even those companies and company managers who also were inspiring the people to go for the war. So we have at least two characters who are committing suicide here. One is the singer Yukio Naguchi, a singer, a popular singer who was motivating young people to go for the war. And we have one manager, president of Kimura Company, and he also committed suicide. Because when the world changed, the world order changed, they all regretted very deeply. They all thought that we are also somewhere responsible for the debacle that we are seeing in Japan. So many people died. Japan is destroyed in this Second World War. And anybody who supported war, imperialism, militarism, nationalism, they all were full of regret. So two characters. Now when we read that story and there's this references come that these two characters commit suicide, we also somewhere think that will our protagonist also commit suicide? Will he also feel very deeply the regret for those paintings that he has made for nationalism and the interest of their nation? And Masuji Ono, will he go on that path? But perhaps Masuji Ono will not go on that path, because he still keep on telling himself that what he did was right. He think that that was the time, and in that time it was right. And other family members and other people said that, well, that was not right. That was deeply wrong. You lost your son also in that. You lost your wife also. His son, Kenji. Kenji is his son, who also joined military, and he died. And so his daughter, son-in-law, they all have a deep hatred for Masuji Ono. But Masuji Ono do not tell that to us, because he is our narrator. He is our narrator, and he is not going to tell us that I am hated by, deeply hated, not implied, not in a visible way, not in a visible way. But in some way, there is some kind of a complex relation of Masuji Ono with his both the daughters, Norika and Setsuko, and his son-in-law also. But he is not telling us that. That is why he becomes unreliable narrator. Whatever he is telling us, how far that is true. We constantly start doubting Masuji Ono's narrative in that context also. So his painting, this character committed suicide. He's also full of regret. He has to change. And now he cannot be proud of what he was in his younger days. He cannot be proud of all his paintings and other kinds of things. In fact, one is ashamed of being an artist of that kind also. One is ashamed. But Masuji Ono is not feeling that regret. Maybe he's not telling us that I am feeling the regret for that. So that is why we say the world has changed. I think you got an idea that what is this changing world? We are trying to look at the title, the artist of the floating world. And we try to read one meaning of the floating, and that is changing world. Everything is floating. You are right now here, and it floats into a different direction. So what is the change that is happening in Japan? Historically, is this that before the around Second World War, you are highly imperialist, you are nationalist, you are supporting war, militarism and everything. And suddenly after Second World War, people, all the citizens of Japan also started believing that anybody who supported this militarism, imperialism, war, emperor, they all were wrong people. It was their error of judgment that entire Japan has to suffer. And all those people now are in a kind of a fix. You have to deeply regret. You can't leave. Many of them are committing suicide. Many of those people are now committing suicide because of regret. So that is floating world, an artist of the floating world that comes here. And we get a very interesting theme. An interesting theme is this, that artist, what is the role of artist in this world? World is going to change. But the value of artist is very important, that even if the world has changed, will the changed world increase your value or decrease it? Will the world, with the changed world, the floating world, is going to increase your value? Or is it going to decrease your value? With the changing time, will the people, the family member of artists, writers, will be proud of the artist and the writer, or they will be ashamed of those writers? Now let us bring a little bit of historical examples here. When Thomas Hardy, in the last semester we are dealing with Thomas Hardy, and we have said that Thomas Hardy's Jude the Obscure, the novel that we have studied, was the last novel. Because after writing that novel, people thought that this is a very bad novel. Such kind of novel should not be written, should not be read by the people. And there was lots of criticism of the novel. And so Thomas Hardy stopped writing novels. He ceased to be a novelist. He started writing poems on. After a couple of generations, now people say that Thomas Hardy was a great writer. We are proud of Thomas Hardy. We are ashamed of those people who said that you are a bad artist, who said that your novel is bad. Now, Masuji Ono's case is reverse, is an opposite case. He was very proud of his painting, that is nationalistic painting, supporting war, imperialism and militarism. And then after the war, everybody is ashamed of his painting. The family members are ashamed of his painting. Maybe even the Japan is ashamed of such writers, such singers, such company presidents, or any of those who supported this, wherein the Japan was completely destroyed. So when this gives us a message that Writers look progressively towards a society where even if the world is going to change, they will maintain their value, because they are looking at humanity first. When you are nationalist, when you are imperialist, when you are warmonger, when you support war in any form, or when you are with the power, that is Emperor Hirohito or Big Brother, then obviously you are somewhere wrong. Even if you are an artist, you do not have a deep insight. You don't have a historical sense that being with emperor, being with warmongers, being with nationalists, you are not going to have a value. Time is going to change very fast. And as soon as the world has floated, drifted in different direction, or as soon as the world has changed, you will be ashamed of yourself. The people who will be living with your memory will be ashamed of your memory, and even perhaps your society, your culture, your religion also may be deeply ashamed of such writers. That is that story of Masuji Ono. That is that interesting story of Masuji Ono, an artist who is deeply in regret for taking a side of imperialism or nationalism, and he used art for that sake. And then we have those writers who made the living people uncomfortable. The priests were uncomfortable by Jude the Obscure. All those snobbish people of society, the moralists, were unsettled, uncomfortable. But today we say that Hardy was a great writer. Hardy stood for a larger humanity, having a more comprehensive soul, the word which was used by Dryden for William Shakespeare, having comprehensive soul. So we have seen this debate around many writers, and then as the time moves on and changes, things may change also. So floating world, floating, that word, that is one meaning that we can give. But still there is a literal meaning also, literal meaning of floating word. And this comes, that floating word is an exact translation of a Japanese word, a Japanese word, and the Japanese word is ukiyo-e. Ukiyo-e is the Japanese word. Let me share this screen so you can see the spelling. Ukiyo-e. This is the word. And floating world is exact translation of this word. Painting. Painting of ukiyo. Or you see the word ukiyo. Ukiyo. So what is ukiyo? Ukiyo means fleeting, floating, transient world, changing world, the world which is not going to remain permanent, but is going to keep on changing, not having a permanence, transient, floating, fleeting. Now, when I see the word floating, also I remember that floating means tartu hoiteu, koi pani ma tartu hoiteu. But that is not the meaning. Floating atle e hawa ma pan tartu hoi. And hawa ma taru atle, if you see smoke floats in an air and then vanishes. And then it vanishes. So that is transient nature of smoke. So that is where ukiyo means a floating. Floating, it's a Japanese. And during Edo period in Japan, that is between 1600 and 1867, almost 267 years. During this period, there was a particular kind of culture that was developing in Japan, a particular kind of culture that was urban lifestyle and culture, urban, rich people, city people, their culture, their lifestyle. And they were all pleasure-seeking, pleasure-seeking people, pleasure-loving, anand pramod karta loko, pramadi loko, pramadi, anand pramod pramadi loko. Obviously, these are rich people, rich people and leisure class. Bau kaam ni chinta na hoi, paisa khub hoi. Pachi tame shu karo, to mushairao karo, mujrao karo, mushaira, mujra. Raat aakhi tamare tyaan party ho chalti hoi, as we have seen in Gatsby also. So that was this culture of Japan also, rich people and that culture. So that was pleasure seeking. And then there is a word pleasure district. Pleasure district એટલે ત્યાં આ પ્રકારના લોકો જ રહેતા હોય, આનંદ પ્રમોદ કરતા હોય, પાર્ટીઓ કરતા હોય, અને અને ગર્લ્સમાં છોકરીઓ બહુ સુંદર થાય, મેકઅપ કરે ખૂબ સરસ મજાના. There are very interesting hairstyles in Japan, so they beautify themselves a lot. And then they dance, like we have Umrao Jan. we can't call it exactly prostitutes, but even prostitution become a part of this. Even prostitution becomes a part of ukiyo culture. But Umrao Jan is a lady who is having a relation, who dances, who sings songs, and have a relation with Nawabi families. But we can say Umrao Jan is a high priced prostitute. It is not a kind of a lowly woman. So that kind of women, and when they are dancing and enjoying that life, artists would sit at a distance and make paintings of these people, and they will keep on painting this people also. And it is drawn on a wooden block, normally it is drawn. So if you see ukiyo paintings, and you will find this kinds of graphics, ukiyo paintings, where you will see many very very graphical painting, very beautiful art. It is a genre of art also, genre of art. And our protagonist Masuji Ono was trained for this painting when he is working under his teacher. His teacher is there are very interesting names and very difficult to remember all the names also. His name of his teacher was Seiji Moriyana, known as Mori-san. Seiji Moriyana, his teacher, when he was under training, Seiji Moriyana was famous for this kind of painting, this all kind of painting there. So you'll find this, there is a book also. There is the book Ukiyo-e, the art of Japanese print. So we are seeing the title ukiyo means floating world. So an artist of ukiyo, the title is artist of ukiyo. Masuji Ono is trained to be an artist of ukiyo, artist of this floating world. So what he is supposed to do, he is supposed to paint this kind of things. He is not supposed to paint nationalism, is not supposed to paint war, is not supposed to paint about imperialism or encouraging people for war. He is supposed to paint about leisure class people, and this world is what he is supposed to do. So this all paintings that you see here in ukiyo, and that is what he is supposed to be, the artist of this. There are very amorous paintings also, amorous painting, people making love, and or even those paintings are also drawn in this there. So that is what is Masuji Ono supposed to be? He's supposed to be the artist of leisure class people, of the floating world, that is ukiyo-e, the pleasure-seeking people. He's not supposed to think about nation. He's not supposed to speak about war, imperialism, emperor. That is not what he's supposed to do. But then when he is under training of this kind of thing, he changes his path. He meets another fellow, that is Matsuda. He meets Matsuda, and Matsuda is a nationalist, imperialist influencer on Masuji Ono. And he told him that, well, true artist has a role towards their country also. They should be dedicated to their country also. And so he changes his path. Masuji Ono is changing his path, and he starts painting for the war, for which at a later age he is going to have a deep regret, for which he is going to have a deep regret for changing his path. Okay, so that is the title, Artist of the Floating World. Okay, any questions here in understanding the title? Two dynamics are there, one a literal meaning and then one a translated word from Japanese culture, Japanese language, that we see as the floating or ukiyo. Our protagonist, the artist, is supposed to be of this world, but he is now a nationalist painter. And when you tell this, you think that, well, it is good. It is, rather than painting such stupid things of leisure class people, it is good to paint something about nation. It is good service to the nation. That is what we would think, and it is a good change. But no, it is not a good change. That is what Ishiguro says, and as a writer, Ishiguro says that this is not a good change. And that is where this novel becomes very interesting. It is not flowing. Ishiguro the writer is not flowing with the mainstream thoughts that if you are thinking nation first and you are dedicating your art for the sake of the nation building, it is good service to the nation. Perhaps not. Sometimes it is not so. Sometimes it is very harmful service artist and the art is utilized, and you can destroy your country. You can encourage people for war and other things also. Okay. Any questions? Anybody here? Okay. So this point we end.